Hello everyone. In this video session, I am going to explain part 53 of Java for Tester series, that is Conditional Operator. There are different operators in Java, and we can categorize all these operators into different types at a high level. So one of the operator types is arithmetic operators. Then we have relational operators. Then we have logical operators. Then we have assignment operators. And finally, we have the last and other operator, that is conditional operator. So as part of the previous videos, I already covered all these different types of operators like arithmetic, relational, logical, and assignment operator. In the current video session, I am going to cover this operator known as conditional operator, which is also known as ternary operator. Okay, this conditional operator is also known as ternary operator, guys. And what is the symbol for using this conditional operator or ternary operator in Java? Symbol for using this ternary operator or conditional operator in Java is question mark followed by colon. Okay, this is a symbol, guys. Question mark colon. Okay, so if I give an example, it will be something like this. Int a is equal to, let's say in one example, guys, int a is equal to, it will be like this. A is equal to, so here let's say b greater than c, question mark d colon e. It can be like this. Okay, here question mark, here symbol, just compare this one of the example with this symbol, guys. Here we have question mark, that question mark is this one, and here we have a colon, and this colon is this one. How this particular conditional operator or ternary operator will work, I am going to explain in detail for you guys. Okay, so but the symbol here is question mark and colon. So how it works, let me explain. Let's take an example, guys. So let's take an example like int a, some b is equal to say 5, comma c is equal to 6, d is equal to 7, and e is equal to 8. Let's take this example. And if I write, I have not assigned anything to the variable a, guys. I have only assigned the four variables, that is I have assigned the variable b with 5 and c with 6, d with 7 and e with 8, but a is not assigned with anything. Now if I say a is equal to, if I say a is equal to, okay, b, if b greater than c, then question mark, okay, d colon e. I'm giving like this. So what actually happens here is, I will explain how this conditional operator, that's question mark colon, will work. I will explain. Okay, in this conditional operator, there before this question mark symbol, there will be an expression, guys, boolean expression. So if you actually operate this, b is greater than c, 5 greater than 6, it will either result in true or false, right? B greater than c will either result in a boolean expression or boolean value, that is true or false. In this case, b is 5 and c is 6. Is 5 greater than 6? No, false. It will result in false case. Okay, if this is false, okay, if this particular condition, boolean expression before this question mark is false, it will take, okay, e, guys. Okay, if it is true, it will take this. If it is false, it will take this. For example, if I say b less than c, okay, here 5 is less than 6 is true. If it is true, it will take d. Okay, it will consider d. But if it is false, this conditional expression will consider e, guys. Okay, only either d or e will be considered, guys. When d is considered, the value stored in the d will be assigned to the variable a. If e is considered, the value stored in the e will be assigned to variable a. One of the d and e will be considered and assigned to the variable a. So based on this expression, okay, based on this expression. Now if I say b greater than c, 5 greater than 6 is false. Since it is false, it will consider e, guys. The value stored in E is 8, so 8 will be assigned to the variable A. And when I print the variable A, you will get the result as 8. Right click run as job application. You see, 8 got displayed. What if I make this B less than C? 5 is less than 6 is true, so it will consider the first one, that is D. The value stored in D is 7. 7 will be assigned to the variable A, and when you print A, 7 will be printed this time. Right click run as job application. Okay, 7. So I can give one more example, guys. Let's say int A is equal to 8, comma B is equal to sum 10. Okay. Here, if I say string S is equal to, if A less than B, okay, conditional operator or ternary operator, then here I will say, double quotes, I will say A is less than B. Okay, if this particular Boolean expression is resulting in true, thus this should be printed. Otherwise, A is not less than B should be printed. Let's say, okay. Now, if I say system.out.println, if I print S, what will be printed, guys? Here A is 8, 8 less than B is true. If it is true, A is less than B will be considered and assigned to this variable SF of string, non-primitive data type. When you print this S, what will be printed? This literal, string literal will be printed. A is less than B will be printed. Right, let's run this. Right click run as Java application. A is less than B. What if I make this 18? What if I make the value as 18? 18 less than 10, false. That means A is not less than B should be printed. So right click run as Java application. A is not less than B will be printed. Okay, so this is how the conditional operator or ternary operator will work. Let's take some more examples, guys, okay, to make you understand this conditional operator more. Let's say int A is equal to 10. Okay, if, or not if, here I will say, I will directly give a conditional expression something like this. If a is less than 20, okay, give a question mark here and give something like if a is less than 20, say minus a, okay, minus a. Here I will say a is equal to again, okay, minus a colon a semicolon. So you see, this is working. So what happens with this conditional expression, conditional operator here is, it will verify this Boolean expression, that is A less than 10, 10 is less than 20, that is true, right? So when 10 is less than 20, this will be considered, this part will be considered. When it is true, when this Boolean expression is resulting in true, this first value will be considered out of these two values separated by colon symbol. So minus A will be considered. So current value of A is 10, so it becomes minus 10, okay? Minus of 10 is minus 10, so minus 10 will be assigned to the variable A. If you say system.out.println A, right click run as job application, you see minus 10 will be printed. So what if I say A greater than 20, okay, reverse, here A is 10, 10 is greater than 20 is false, okay, so it will consider the second value of A, that is 10, so it will be 10 only, 10 will be assigned to the variable A. When you print A, 10 will be printed. Right click run as job application. You see, 10 will be printed. Like this, guys, you can use conditional operator, okay, with different literals. It may not be only integer literal every time. It can be string literal. It can be, okay, it can be anything, guys, okay. The literals can be anything. So it should be a Boolean expression, and this is like conditional operator symbols, and this value 1 or value 2 will be considered based on this result. If it is true, this will be considered. If it is false, this will be considered, and the result will be assigned to the variable, any variable, okay, and printed. So this is how we have to use conditional operator or ternary operator, also known as ternary operator in Java, guys. In the next video session, I will explain the other topic on operators in Java, that is operator precedence, okay. The operator precedence topic I am going to explain as part of the next video session. So that's it, guys. See you in the next video session. Thank you. Bye.